Today we have a very interesting interview question that is like how to make sure a web application is healthy, how do you monitor the web application, or sometimes you can be asked a question to design a monitoring tool for your web application. Let's see how to do this. Why do we monitor the web application, right? So however you do a lot of load testing or performance testing, you have to monitor the web application in the real time for multiple reasons, right? So let's see one by one, right? So you want to know how many users are visiting your page, that is highly visited web page, right? That's one reason. And let's say you want to know how many users are logged into the system. Or you might be even interested to know the browser type, whether it's an Internet Explorer or Google Chrome or Safari, right? And you may also be interested to know the bandwidth of the system. For example, you want to know how many data is transacted through each port of the system. And you also need to know the CPU spikes, disk out of space. Let's say if the CPU spikes, your system can get crashed, right? Also the disk, when the hard disk runs out of the space, your system could get crashed, right? So you have to monitor this and make sure you get an appropriate alert to take appropriate decisions, right? And we also need to set up a right alerting mechanism where if any of the issues are happening in the system, it has to be alerted to the production support team so that they can take a necessary action to make sure the system is running in the smooth. And there are a lot of reasons you have to alert or sorry, a lot of reasons you have to monitor the system. And I've not discussed much on that. And now let's see what are the real ingredients needed for monitoring. So basically you need a web server logs. If you have a Tomcat server or WebLogic server, you might be getting two important logs. One is the access log and the error logs. The error logs are going to have the error information, and access logs are going to have the information related to the number of request URLs, the session information, and the web pages you are calling, etc., right? Or the web services you are calling. So we need those information to build the right monitoring system, right? And you can also use beacons. The beacons are nothing but an image which is deployed in a separate server, and you add the link to that server or you add the link to that image into all your web pages. And instead of monitoring in your Tomcat logs or the WebLogic log, you can monitor or get a lot of information from the server where the web beacon image is deployed, right? That is one of the way we can do it. But that will not give a lot of information, but still, you know, if you want, you can use it and get some more information rather than getting from the Tomcat logs or the web server logs. And you'll also have a load balancer logs. The load balancer log also provides a lot of information like to which server the transaction is happening and how the session stickiness is happening. And these informations are also really required to set a monitoring system or a monitoring tool. And the next one is bandwidth. So if you want to know about the bandwidth of the system, the protocol available is SNMP, which is Simple Network Management Protocol. And you can use that protocol, and there are a lot of Java APIs available, and you can use those protocol to connect with your different servers. And from that server, you can get informations like CPU capacity, the disk space, the bandwidth information, etc. And it can be stored in a different file or it's stored in a database. And later that information can be used for monitoring. Right. And let's say most of the applications will be having a MySQL. If you want to get information related to the MySQL, you have a MySQL logs, and based on appropriate configuration, you will get information like what is the query time which is taking to load fast or which is taking to load slow. And you can also see how many databases are connected or how many slaves are configured, etc. And there are a lot of comments like show status where you'll get information about MySQL. And this information can be passed to the different file system where you can parse those files and get the information to build the analytical tool or a monitoring system, right? And there is also if you have a memcache installed in your application, you have a memcache status command, which I showed on the screen, and this can be used to get the memcache information, and this information also can be used to build the monitoring tool, right? And even though you have all those informations, you also need to write an appropriate alerting mechanism so that you know if there is any issue happening across your system, you can alert it to the appropriate production support or production engineering team to take an appropriate actions, right? So here I'm using a tool called Neguez where it can use to configure and with your system so that you know it can send the alerting based on your configuration. For example, if your CPU goes beyond a certain limit, you want to send an alert, right? So you can all configure based on whatever you need, right? Okay, now let's go into the important topic, how to design or how to set up a alerting system on your own. So let's say if you have deployed your application in AWS, you have a straightforward tool or a direct tool like, you know, CloudWatch, where you can configure everything and get those information. But here the question is, you are going to design or set up a system on your own without utilizing any of the directly available cloud watching or cloud monitoring tools, right? So let's see how we are doing this. If you look at the system, this is a very simple web application where you have a clients on the left side and then you have a load balancer, and the load balancer in turn connects to multiple app servers, probably the Tomcat server or WebLogic server, and all these are connecting back into the SQL database. This is a very simple system. Let's see how we set up a monitoring tool or an alerting mechanism into that, right? So now if you see in the system, you will most probably have a logs in all the Tomcat servers, right? So if you want to use all the logs, we cannot, it's very difficult for us to query each and every Tomcat and get the log information. Instead, what I'm doing here is I'm sending all the log messages to the queue, and queue in turn will connect into a different machine and where all your log information or log files are stored. After that, what happens here is we can use this log information which has been collected in that machine, and you can parse it and extract to get an appropriate monitoring information like a chart or a graph, whatever it is, you can get it. In that, you can get whatever we discussed earlier, right? Like how many pages are viewed, how many errors are happening, etc., can be fetched by querying the logs from this log server, right? Also, if you see, you will be getting a logs into the SQL server, right? We can even fetch those logs and pass into the systems like Ganglia, where it helps to parse the logs and provide an analytical reports out of that. So Ganglia is an out of scope in this, but it's an excellent monitoring tool if you want to set up on your own, right? And this Ganglia tool can also be directly connected to the different VMs where the Tomcat server is running, and you can get more information like, you know, the bandwidth, etc., by connecting to the SNMP protocols, right? So you can see that in the picture how the connections are happening between the different servers to collect the appropriate informations, right? So now finally we have to set up an alerting mechanism to send an appropriate alert to different production engineering group, right? So here I'm using a tool called Negoes. What it does is we can directly integrate that tool with the Ganglia, and based on the configurations, it can send the appropriate alert, right? So for example, if a CPU is spiking or if it is going beyond a 70% capacity, then you want to send an alerting message. Or if your hardware is going beyond a capacity of 90%, then we want to send an alerting message, right? So that the appropriate persons can pitch into that and have an extra hardware added into that, right? So this is what I'm setting up on Negoes, and you can configure that and you can have appropriate alerting messages. So what we discussed over is a very simple system design for setting up your own alerting mechanism or setting up your own monitoring tool, right? Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Bye.